For bees, as well as human beings, it is important to smell good. But the orchid does not give away its perfume for nothing. It has a wonderfully designed and harmless trap for the bees. Thanks to this trap, it can load its pollen onto them. There is a very slippery floor at the entrance to the place where the perfume is. It is very difficult for the male bee to land there. Of course, there is a reason for the slippery floor. Now, watch carefully. The bee falls into the trap. As he struggles to escape, he comes into contact with the yellow pollen. And the pollen sticks to the bee's body. The wonderful trap has worked. Another species of orchid uses another method to load its pollen. A booby trap. There is a very sweet-smelling nectar here to attract bees. That extension you see is the orchid's booby trap. This bee you see is not big enough to set the trap mechanism into motion. But this one is. The bee comes into contact with the trap's trigger mechanism, and in a split second, pollen sticks to the bee. The design of the cypress orchid is another wonder of creation. The designs you see on the screen are a one-to-one model of a female bee. These are blue, wing-shaped designs. There are hair-like projections on the body. In the sunlight, the wings of a female bee take on a blue color. And just like the orchid, its body is covered with hairs. The orchid imitates the female bee perfectly. Yet, this is not the whole miracle. The female bee excretes a special chemical substance to attract the male bee. It is amazing that the orchid produces the same chemical substance to attract the male bee. So, the pollen sticks to it. The male bee takes this pollen with it when it goes to another orchid, and the other orchid is fertilized by the pollen. Here we see another miracle of creation. An orchid is a plant. It has no eyes to see the outside world and no brain to interpret what it sees. The fact that a plant can imitate a living thing it has never seen and can never know, from its wings to its hairs and from its color to its smell, is proof that God created both the plant and the bee. The South African female wasp has no wings. She spends a large amount of her time under the ground. When it comes time to mate, the female bee comes to the surface and climbs up a plant. There she secretes a special odor to attract male wasps and waits for them to arrive. And usually she does not have to wait long. The male wasp flies to her, picks her up, and they fly away together. The reproductive system of the hammer orchid that grows in South Africa is another miracle of creation, and it has a wonderful engineering design. The flower part of the orchid resembles a wingless female wasp. The flower produces a copy of the perfume produced by the female wasp. The male wasp thinks that this miniature model is a female wasp and tries to fly away with it. But of course, he can't. So, what's the use of this to the orchid? The answer lies hidden in the orchid's ingenious design. The purple area on the left is a model of the female wasp. In the little sac on the right, there is sticky pollen. This compartment, which includes the model of the female wasp, is attached to the plant by a small but strong joint. When stimulated, this joint allows the female wasp model to move towards the pollen sac. When the bee attempts to pick up the female and fly away, he comes into contact with the pollen sac because of this mechanical design. There, the pollen is stuck to the bee. When pollen unites with the female cell, the plant is fertilized, and a while later, a seed appears. A seed ensures the continuation of that plant species, and each one of them is an example of God's creative artistry. In the Quran, God particularly draws attention to the creation of a seed. Have you thought about what you cultivate? Is it you who make it germinate, or are we the germinator? If we wished we could have made it broken stubble, you would then be left devoid of crops, distraught. In the autumn, a special kind of fungus appears on the forest floor. The earth star. On first glance, its plainness belies the wonderful design it contains. As time passes and the humidity in the air grows, earth stars undergo a major change. Their skin cracks open, and a very special weapon comes out from inside the plant. This is a real shooting system. And it is a very special system created to project the spores, that is, the seeds of the plant, over a great distance. The leaves you see stabilize the mechanism on the ground. And this is the barrel that will do the shooting. A drop of rain triggers the mechanism. It shoots. The wind will carry these spores great distances, and the fungus will reproduce its species. Some flowers use air transport to spread their seeds. Under each of these white balls, there are about 100 seeds. These seeds are bigger than the spores of the Earth stars, and they need a special device to enable them to stay aloft. And inside each seed, there is a special ready-made flying mechanism. A parachute. This parachute is so effective that even a light breeze will let the seeds waft high into the air. Each one of these tiny helicopters you see carries a seed. The size of the seed and the length and design of the wing display a wonderful harmony. Now, let's pause a moment and look at the details of this system. Here is a real design. The scale, size, and weight of the flight system are completely designed to transport the seed. Even the distance between the seed and the mechanism is adjusted to balance the center of gravity. If this mechanism were any shorter or longer, the seed could not fly. Human beings use parachutes. There is one very important point that must not be forgotten. Those who designed parachutes were individuals with knowledge and intelligence. The flowers that use much more effective parachutes than the ones human beings use are only plants. They have no intelligence or consciousness. But thanks to God's incomparable creation, these plants construct perfect flight mechanisms. This presents us with an evident miracle. And this miracle is proof that God created every living thing on the face of the earth. Here is the Amazon rainforest. In the Amazon rainforest, the air is generally hot and humid. The wind almost never blows. This makes air transport difficult. That's why plants must provide their seeds with much more wonderful flight equipment. For example, a double wing. Just beneath the wings you see here is the seed of a tree. Aircraft designers have tried to design a wing as effective as this, but they have not been able to. Man-made aircraft fly much less effectively. And these aircraft have been designed by intelligent and knowledgeable engineers.